We continue here on TYT Sports. That is Denise. I am Rick. Serena Williams now appearing on your screen.
Damn, darn it.
You gonna do me like that?
Darn it.
All right, so this is a serious story. You can take the superhero out of her costume, but you can never take away her superpowers. This is Nike sticking up for their athlete. And the reason being, it is a medical reason. I've had a lot of problems with my blood clots. God, I don't know how many I've had in the past 12 months. I've been wearing pants in general a lot when I play so I can keep the blood circulation going. She has dealt with this previously. She has dealt with this because of her pregnancy, where she had to have emergency surgery after emergency surgery to save her life and her baby's life. So there is a reason she has what many are deeming is the catsuit. Mm-hmm. So here comes this jabroni in France, Bernard von Face, who says, President of the French Tennis Federation made this relatively horrifying statement. We are going to nonetheless ask the manufacturers to let us know what outfits are coming. I believe we have sometimes gone too far. Serena's outfit this year, for example, would no longer be accepted. You have to respect the game and the place. Respect the game?
Yeah, how about you put some respect on her name? Because she's not the first person to have this suit. She's not the first, second, or third. We've seen pictures of Anne White, and she's from like the 80s, mm-hmm. to have a suit there like this. And it's just like, the reason it is such a big deal and the reason the French are talking about it in the way that they are is because, let's be honest, Serena has curves. She's a curvaceous woman. She's loud, she's aggressive. Her body is full of muscle and it's empowering.
Which she's been faulted for.
So many times. It's empowering as a woman to see another woman just be able to do all of that with her body, carry herself in the way that she does, and still have the sweetest, kindest voice every time she carries herself in conversations. You mentioned the blood clots. Blood clots is something that she, along with other injuries, is something that she's been suffering with her entire life. Yeah. And after her pregnancy, which by the way, she got so much ish for because for a year, for taking a year off to have a baby,
okay?
After this pregnancy, she initially planned to have a traditional mm-hmm. birth, but because of complications or she had like a 14-hour, she was in labor for 14 hours, something along those lines, she had to get surgery, something that she was trying to avoid, her and her fiance were trying to avoid at the time. And then they have the surgery because they have to. So the blood clots get even worse. So now she's forced to wear this suit, something that I'm sure is not comfortable. I'm sure
probably
it's not something that she wants to wear. I'm sure she's straining her body even more just being on the court. But here she is doing her best and she's still getting ridiculed for it.
Right.
And in something again, that's not new to her.
So let's pull up this Anne White photo again. Cause it's, let's be honest, it looks like a spacesuit. It does. Yet the reaction for when she wore that via Vox, as one tennis retailer put it, it's attractive. But you have to be built like Anne White is to wear it. And the rest of the world is not. So then years ago, Serena Williams wore a tennis outfit. Literally a tennis outfit.
Traditional tennis outfit.
Very traditional. The outfit was described in the press as clinging, ultra risque, curve clutching.
Bingo.
And leaving little to the imagination. And then they went on to say, other media outlets pointed out Williams' bulging muscles, defensive back physique. And one described her as a working girl of a different sort, calling the catsuit trashy.
Yeah, first.
Go ahead.
Those were compliments, I was just gonna say.
Right.
A defensive back right. physique.
Give me those lat pull downs every once in a while.
Compliment me on my back, please, because it's so hard to get muscles back there. Keep yeah. complimenting her, please.
Seriously, compliment us in the media as well, please. When we have them. So here is where this gets very serious and why I believe this is rooted in a disgusting racial history in France. And not only that, as I'm going to touch on, in America. This is in 2001. Venus Williams and Serena Williams' father in France via USA Today. When Venus and I were walking down the stairs to our seats, people kept calling me the N-word. One guy said, I wish it was 75, we'd skin you alive. That's when I stopped and walked toward that way. Then I realized that my best bet was to handle the situation nonviolently. I had trouble holding back tears. I think Indian Wells, which is where the French Open is held, disgraced America. Anna Kournikova went on to say, I hate my muscles. I'm not Venus, I'm not Serena, I'm feminine. I don't want to look like they do. I'm not masculine like they are. American tennis legend Chris Evert, who I believe is an ESPN tennis analyst, said both sisters' athletic ability and raw aggression make it hard for, quote, the women who aren't Amazons to compete with them. Another incident. Australian umpire Denise Overberg penalized Venus Williams on break point in the third game for causing a disturbance because a bead fell out. Venus went on to say, as if I was doing this on purpose. Do you see me pulling hair, pulling them out? This is out of control, is what she went on to say. What we have here is a double standard, whether it is in France or in America, between a successful black tennis player infiltrating, in their own opinion, a mainly white sport and adding a little flair and flavor. I had no idea that this was so bad and disrespecting the game. What needs to happen today is whatever is the, I don't care about his name. The French tennis president needs to step down today.
Yeah.
If France wants to somehow vindicate itself from all of this, which by the way, did not have to happen, and having an uproar with us, rightfully so, and many others who not only support Serena Williams, but also tennis players, and on top of that, female tennis players, what needs to happen is you need to get rid of the bad.
Right.
This tennis president is horrible. This is deeply rooted, again, and I believe his own beliefs of what should happen, what should not happen. This is not disrespecting the game. It is not at all. What you're doing is disrespecting us and disrespecting Serena Williams.
And we're also aware that he's not the first and only person with these thoughts. It's something that, you know, Serena and many people of color have been going through for years. And that's why for a long time you've been taught that you can't have trigger words. Like you can't have trigger words. There can't be. And it's so unfortunate because Richard Williams, to have to hear that, you know, at his daughter's, you know, match with his other daughter next to him is absolutely humiliating, and it's something that no one should have to endure. But, you know, here he is using, you know, his best judgment and holding back tears is absolutely heartbreaking to hear, because when you watch, when you watch the ad that came after this one with the superhero one saying, you hear Richard Williams saying like, okay, this is you telling a young Serena, like this is you at the US Open, right? Richard Williams has been nothing but an encouraging father, something that people of color don't have a lot of. You don't hear about these promising stories with fathers included. And you have one here and you see the success that comes out of it when you have a traditional family like the one that they have, when they come from the upbringing that they do and they've been able to rise in the way that they have. And you know, it's because of that that she has a company like Nike behind her who was able to capitalize on the moment in the best way, because they could have easily just hushed and taken the backseat, but they didn't. They capitalized on the moment. They called her suit a superhero
suit.
So
important.
And it's very important and very on time, because not only was Serena able to capitalize on this, but her influence spoke volumes because of the fans, because of the brands and everything that comes with her.
So good on Nike. Serena, we're behind you. And hopefully the French Tennis Association riddles the toxicity that is going on at the top. Let us know your thoughts. Comment section below. Subscribe to TYT Sports. Do you hate seeing this face? Check out the TYT Podcast Network. Go to tyt.com/audio to check out more.